So I feel like there's a silver lining there, if there ever was one. Maybe.
Maybe it's also because I have all these pillows around
me. Am I reaching? Hello, everybody. We are Geek Accident. I am Robbie.
I'm Rebecca.
And welcome back to Movie Swap. It's a new week. New movies.
Mm-hmm.
And I figure we'll just stick with the same formula. You can go first.
Okay. Well, I watched, you gave me Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil.
Bring your mic down a little bit more. There we go. Yes.
I'm trying to hide my face. I watched Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, a movie I have never heard of.
Yeah.
But I liked it. It was very 90s.
Well, yeah.
But I really enjoyed it. It was good. You little baby Jude Law.
Isn't he cute?
He was so cute. He's so his cute. Little his little southern accent. Kevin Spacey kind of being a predator of some sort.
I mean, that's fitting. Is that not fitting?
I loved John Cusack and Lady... oh my God, I can't think of her name.
What is her name?
Lady Chaplain? Something like that.
Yeah, I cannot remember her name.
They had such great chemistry on screen. It was great. I loved it. Who is the woman in that movie? I forgot to look it up, but I have never seen her in anything else.
Lady Chablis, I think, before
Lady Chablis, which I think was her...
Lady Chablis is her actual name.
Yeah, her real name.
Yeah.
Was.
You mean...
She passed away.
The lady, like the love interest?
Yeah.
Clint Eastwood's daughter?
Like, oh, is that really?
Yeah.
Wow, no clue.
Mandy.
She was cute.
Allison Eastwood.
Yeah, I don't know. I liked it. It was good. I would watch it again, definitely.
You sound like you didn't like it, though. Like, it was good.
No, it was good. I would suggest it to other people to watch. It was just so, I don't know, the editing was bizarre. There was like weird cuts. I don't know. It didn't bother me a lot, but it was strange.
Okay.
The cuts between the scenes. But I feel like because it's a book adapt that cut a lot out, and you could tell that there are some things that needed more
what
fleshing
the
out.
What the fuck is happening here?
You're like all tangled.
I know. I don't like, what is happening? What is going on? You stay there. There are a couple of quirky jumps, and there where you could tell that like something else needed to go there.
Yeah, yeah. But it was cute. The town was so cute. Everything. I really enjoyed it. I would definitely.
What did you
watch
think
again.
About the shift in tone? Like, you know, because it's
from the beginning with all the quirkiness, and then it just is like murder.
Yeah, and then you've got that weird ass. Little scene where, like, Jude Law is like lying down on the ground, and then he like
at the end,
and it's like I said, it's a little supernatural.
It is a little,
you know.
Fuck,
now I have to go back and watch this movie.
Yeah, slightly supernatural. I think it's the only because they're in the graveyard a lot too.
Yeah, I mean, it's just I feel like it's
they're in Georgia, so of course there's gonna be
exactly like they're in Georgia. Obviously, there's gonna be some of that black magic.
Yeah,
but you did like it.
No, I did. I really enjoyed it.
Did you have any problems with it? Because you had the gripe last week about Joey Pants.
No, I didn't. I set myself up for
you
disappointment.
You really,
there.
Really, really did. How'd you like that Dadoff Schmittler thing?
Huh?
Did you watch the video? Remember when you're asking, like, what's it called when, like, they act like a good guy and they're revealed to be a bad guy? It's called Evil All Along.
Yeah.
Did you not see that thing down at the bottom that said it's also known as a Dadoff Schmittler?
No, I didn't see it. I mean, I didn't watch the whole video.
It was like the third fucking minute.
Okay, well, sorry.
Jeez and rice, woman.
Yeah, I didn't know that. But that there was none of that in this movie.
No, there was not. No, everyone was pretty cut and dry.
There was a guy that one. Kept threatening the town that he was going to poison them, which was bizarre.
Yeah, a little bit. Little
Lots
bit.
Lots of quirky little guys in this movie.
Dude, honestly, some of it, you wouldn't think it's a Clint Eastwood movie just because it's so quirky.
Yeah.
A little bit. Like, that's not typically his style.
Yeah, I don't know what made him direct this movie.
I don't know, man. Maybe he just enjoyed the idea or something.
It's possible. Yeah, I don't know.
It's entirely possible.
Do you know what the first movie he directed was?
God, no. Could not even tell you.
Hmm.
So you'd recommend it to another person?
I would recommend it.
Anything about the movie you really loved or you would watch it again?
Yeah, I just really loved John Cusack's chemistry with Lady Chaplain.
Chablis.
I'm sorry. Lady
Chablis.
Lady Chablis. They had great chemistry.
Good night, woman.
They made it very enjoyable they really to did. Watch.
Yeah. I love that a lot. I really loved her character.
Yeah.
I thought she was super fucking awesome.
Yeah, like from her, the character introduction to the last scene, she was great.
Yeah.
It's just fantastic.
Oh, she's so, so amazing. Awesome. So, like, we still got to come up with our own rating system. Yeah. But, like, out of 10 right now, what would you say?
Oh, I'd give it, like, a B+.
Okay.
Like, an 8 out of 10.
Okay. I'll take that.
Yeah.
8.5 if it's going to be a B+.
Yeah, if it's a B+, it's like an 8.5.
Is what I just said.
A B plus. Yeah. Highly suggest it.
Good. Cool. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I think that is like top, like number 9 in my top 10. Like it's for sure. I only watch that movie like once every couple years just to kind of like save myself.
I've never heard of it. I'm sure it's been on like TV at some point, but I never heard of it. So thank you for
You're welcome.
Bringing it to my knowledge. Sorry, I'm looking at
I can tell you're really cutting down on the energy right now.
Apparently he directed an adaptation of The Bridges of Madison County in 1995.
What?
Yeah, I don't know.
Wow.
Yeah, he did direct like a bunch of movies before he directed Midnight in the
This was definitely not his first one.
No. But he had a tonal shift.
He did.
What did you watch?
I watched a little movie called Inkheart.
Mm-hmm.
And I gotta tell you, it was like American Graffiti all over again.
Are you kidding me?
I am kidding you, yes.
It's so good! Wow, I cannot believe it.
No, man, like I put that on this morning because I couldn't sleep. And I was sucked in. I like the premise.
Mm-hmm.
I like the powers of all the characters. I like how they incorporated a shitload of characters from a shitload of literary works. It mm-hmm. wasn't just like that one book. So it was like, I feel like somewhere along the way, it could have been, aside from like the opening Red Riding Hood thing, it could have been misconstrued that Inkheart was the only one that they could do that with.
Yeah.
You know, but since they added so many characters like the flying monkeys and the ticking crocodile and mm-hmm. and all that jazz, I think that's like fantasy at its best. You know, that's the idea that someone can bring literary characters to life just by reading out loud. And it could be a very, very, very corny piece of dialogue, but Brendan Fraser, in all of his glory, is just like, I don't read out loud anymore. You know that. And like, it could be like, okay, so you don't read out loud. Big fucking whoop. But like, he has this gravitas to it where it's just like, oh, this is real. I loved it, man. I thought the cast was great.
Oh, did you really love it? I thought you said it was American Graffiti all over again.
You asked if I was kidding, and I said yes. I'm totally kidding.
Okay.
Do you even listen to me when we do this shit?
Apparently not.
It was like American Graffiti all over again.
Are you kidding me?
I am kidding you, yes.
It's so good!
Good God, woman.
Yeah, I'm so glad you loved it.
Oh, I loved it. I'm going to have to pick that one up myself just to have it on my shelf.
It's a little like I never probably would have seen it because I've never heard of this movie before, but I think it was like Blockbuster was going out of business or something.
Yeah, you said that.
And I picked it up out of the bin and it was like they were doing like 5 movies for $10 or whatever. And you just
God, I miss those
bought
sales.
Whatever you could get. And it was like in that bin.
I miss those sales so much. They don't do that shit anymore.
No.
Because they don't sell physical shit anymore. I swear to God, I'm going to be like the last person on earth that has a physical movie disc collection.
Because
mm-hmm. nobody does that shit anymore. Like, it's gotten so hard to find some stuff.
Really?
I remember, dude, not that this matters. I remember going to Best Buy and just having those aisles and aisles and aisles. And now they have like one teeny tiny little section.
I think online they have like a big online thing.
They do. I mean, I typically buy all my shit. Like all the Die Hard movies I just bought in one blow on Amazon.
Yeah.
Inkheart, dude, I would actually have to say like an A-. Like
I would
just give that like a straight 9 out of 10.
Wow.
Because I love that shit. Like I love the fantasies. That's why I love superhero movies so much. It's something that could never happen in real life. And it's fun. But this movie also had, like, I mean, the stakes were there. Reuniting with his wife was, like, you know, mm-hmm. pretty... I can't even think of the word right now. Like, heartwarming. It had every chance to be a cheesy, corny tale of whimsy.
Yeah.
And instead, it took itself seriously, and it was just this awesome, again, fantasy at its best.
Yeah.
I would give it a 9 out of 10. I straight up love this movie.
Yay.
It was a great pick. Thank you so much. I'm gonna buy it. And yeah, and that's it.
Yeah.
I loved it.
Isn't Brendan Fraser such a cute little dad? I love him.
He is. That first scene where he's just like, let me read it to her.
Like, oh, I don't know.
He's just like,
this was like peak Brendan Fraser too. Yeah. Like, heartthrob Brendan Fraser.
I really wish there were more.
The DVD. Yeah, look at him. He's so cute.
I really wish there were more. Like, it's based on a series of books, and I guess this one didn't do that well.
Oh, are these real books?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know that. I thought this is a made up book.
No, the author actually modeled her main character after Brendan Fraser and insisted he play that character in the movie. Oh,
wow. You looked this up.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Or did you watch special features?
No, I always look shit up. Like,
yeah.
I had to rewind a few scenes because I was like balls deep in IMDb and Wikipedia. And I was like, what the fuck did I miss? Yeah, so I loved it. You liked, didn't love Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil.
Yeah, I'm not going to like rave about it, but it was a really good movie.
Loved Inkheart.
I suggest that movie to everyone. Have you seen Inkheart? No? Watch it.
Watch it.
It's so good.
Have you seen it?
Have you seen it? No.
Watch it.
That's basically how it goes.
I loved it, man. I really did.
Yeah. Yay.
So we had
two winners
this week. Yeah, two winners this week. Yeah. P.S. Fuck American Graffiti. I will die on that hill.
Should we switch?
Yeah, I'm only going to... Let me look up and see if mine is streaming. I'm willing to bet it's not. It's a pretty old... Not old, but whatever.
You never know.
Hang on. I got to spell it right. I'm trying really hard to not, like, breathe into the microphone. So, You can rent it on YouTube and Amazon Prime for $2.99.
Okay.
Or I could just bring it over to your house so you don't have to pay for it.
Yeah, or I can just pick it up when you're working either.
Or that. Yeah.
Whatever, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, I'll just keep it on me or something.
You want to go first then since you're...
Yeah, I will. I'm going to put a picture of it. Oh, speaking of pictures, hang on one fucking second.
Yeah? I know it's crooked, right?
Oh, it bothered the shit out of me the entire time.
When I was watching, I was like, oh, crap, that one picture is crooked.
I think that's better. Dude,
I don't think it sits flat. I think that's the problem.
Oh, come on.
The wall might be crooked. Like, the wall might be, like, not even.
How does it up there? Is it just hanging on one thing?
I don't. It's only one thing.
So it's not one that has, like, a couple of a... Oh, my God, it's pissing me off.
Wow.
Yes, I will put a picture of the movie right here. It's called Sleepers.
I've heard of it. I've never seen it.
I'm just going to give you a heads up.
Okay.
And I'm not going to say anything else about it. This movie will absolutely break your heart.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I'm talking like Ludacris's feature on Tayo Cruz's Heartbreaker. Break your heart and shatter and splatter it into a bunch of little pieces. Like, this movie is intense.
Okay.
Yeah. I love this. This is probably number 10 in my top 10.
Okay. All right. I'm excited.
You should be.
Not for my heart to be broken, but that's fine.
It'll be fun.
I have.
What you got?
I don't know if you've seen this movie. I feel like we had a conversation about it back in like October, but I don't know if you've actually seen it, but I saw it in my DVD collection, and I was like, maybe this one.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
Oh, sweet.
Hell yeah.
Okay, so I gave him Ghost Ship.
Ghost Ship.
Juliana Margulies. Who the fuck else isn't? Idris. No, wait. Idris isn't in this. I'm thinking of Prometheus for some reason. There are, what's his name from Lord of the Rings and Star
Gandalf
Trek?
The Grey?
And he's Leonard in The Boys.
Nimoy? No. He's in The Boys?
He's in The Boys and he's in Lord of the Rings. He's in Star Trek.
Dude, you got to give me like a name or something before I can tell you who it is.
Give you a name? Oh, like the characters he plays?
No, his name.
I don't know his name. I can't think of it.
Gabriel Byrne.
No, what did you look up?
I looked up Ghost Ship.
No, that's not him.
Isaiah Washington.
No, let me see.
God damn it. Carl Urban?
Yes, Carl Urban. Thank you. Carl Urban.
Okay.
It's good.
Okay, cool. I am so looking forward to it.
It's like every October I have to watch that movie.
Every October.
And this is a random fact. Over Halloween this year, I saw this movie. I think it was on Amazon Prime for free. It was called like Haunted Ship or like something like that, or like Ghost Cruise. And I put it on because I just wanted to watch garbage. And literally, I think Ghost Ship is a remake of this movie. I have to find it. We can put it in the description. But literally the same movie. But awesome. Like made shitty in like the 70s.
Sure.
Or early 80s, something like that.
So like this movie is a ripoff of that one, but it's better.
Oh, it's way better. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. That other movie's weird.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Excellent. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on Movie Swap. Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil got a B+. Inkheart absolutely gets an A. We got two more for next week. I'm Robbie.
I'm Rebecca.
Please check us out on, I know you might be on Facebook. Check us out on YouTube. Please subscribe. If we get 100 subscribers, we can be youtube.com/geekaccident. And I'm super anal about that shit because right now we're .com/
XYZ. So, yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Please subscribe. Don't forget to like it. If you like the movie, share it. Or the video, share it. I hate whoring myself out
friends.
On social media. Tell your friends. And we will see you next week.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I hope you enjoy that drinking game, by the way. I listened to the very end of it, and I am embarrassed.
Oh, I didn't feel well the next day.
No. No. I've never had a hangover before in my life. It took me a day to recover.
Oh, yeah. I was pretty down, like, that whole Thursday. I was, like, done. Yeah,
I had that text message from you. I'm so hungover, I'm dying.
Yeah, like, literally.
I'm so hungover, I want to die.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, all right. Have you ever seen, I'll tell you later.
Okay.
I'll tell you later.